Hello everyone, welcome you all to Periyar Screen. Here we have Kumaresan from Dravidar Kalakam, who is going to share his view on why Periyar has been in trend. And one more question, that why rationalist or else Periyarist and Ambedkarist do criticize Hindu right-wing outfits alone? So the both questions he is going to answer. Welcome sir, welcome on behalf of Periyar Screen.
Dear friends, for the past few days, many of our friends, they would be reading as well as watching, both in print media as well as electronic media, certain untoward incident that has happened in Tamil Nadu. Certain miscreants, they have poured saffron colored liquid on the statue of Periyar in Coimbatore. It is needless to point out who the miscreants are. They are unable to establish in Tamil Nadu through their ideology. Because of that failure only, they are taking this route as if they are damaging the ideology of Periyar. Actually, they can't damage. No one can damage Periyar ideology. It shows the cowardly activities of the miscreants. Periyar's progressive ideology of equality and providing equality, equal opportunity to all, cannot be rooted out from this land of Periyar, that is Tamil Nadu, because the wide population of Tamil Nadu got benefited because of the social contribution of Periyar for the past more than 70, 80 years, as well as nearly 100 years of Dravidian movement. To that much extent, Periyar has contributed to the people of Tamil Nadu. Not only Tamil Nadu, beyond Tamil Nadu, wherever people are oppressed in the name of religion, in the name of God, Periyar has uplifted those people. To that much extent, Periyar is successful. They are unable to damage Periyar. Because of that only, they are taking all these activities. Actually, Dravidar Kalakam, founded by Periyar, is continuously carrying out the propaganda activities. The unique mode of doing propaganda by Dravidar Kalakam is, it is devoid of any violence. It is through peaceful means. It is through propaganda of ideology. The cadets of Dravidar Kalakam, right from the days of Periyar, they are doing the social service, social reform activities, social revolutionary activities in Tamil Nadu. Actually, if the miscreants, they want to fight against the Periyar cadets, they have to fight ideologically only. They know very well they can't fight ideologically. Because of that only, they are doing all this activity. This is not the first time they are doing. During the past, such sort of incidents had happened in Tirupathur of Vellore district, in Kanjipuram district, one place Thothakudi in near Vedaranyam in Nahapetnam. Even yesterday also, in near Tirukoyilu, there is one place called Keelayur. There also, they did some activity by garlanding the chapels, garland of chapels on Periyar statue. All these activities, if they are bold enough, they can do during daytime, but they can't do. If they do during the daytime, definitely not even Periyar cadets are required. Even general public, they will oppose. They can't carry out, they accomplish their activities. Actually, this is not new to Periyar movement. It happened when Periyar was alive. Even worse than this had happened to Periyar himself. But the history has proved it has offset such insult, the so-called incel activities, with a due honor. In one place, that is in Kadalur, a statue was erected for Periyar. In the same place, some 2-3 decades back, chapels were thrown at Periyar himself. Wherever chapel was thrown, a statue of Periyar was erected. That was the history in Tamil Nadu. That is the popularity Periyar is having in Tamil Nadu. Nobody can damage. The peculiar thing is, rule of law is taking place in this state as well as in this country. Whether such sort of activity can be allowed? Actually, when the present government, which bears the name Dravidian in its name, not only that, the same AADMK party is using the symbol, the photo of Periyar in their party meetings as well as whenever they seek vote from the public at the time of election. For that purpose, they require Periyar. They are in the ruling side. Such sort of activities are happening abundantly with more frequencies in Tamil Nadu. What this government is doing? Can they simply spectate this namesake? They are filing file. In one case that happened in Dharapuram, they filed the case against the miscreant. The same case was closed as if the miscreant was insane. Knowing fully well, the miscreant wanted to damage Periyar's statue, but the file was closed like that. This is one incident. No concrete action was taken by the present ruling party against the miscreants. This is the sorry state of affairs. Actually, Periyar cadets, they know how to tackle this problem. But we don't have any belief in violence. Ideologically, we will fight against those people. Actually, what is the reason these miscreants they are quoting? Some cadets, they did propaganda against the religious scriptures. They are telling like that. For that, the miscreants, what they have to do? Created by the cadets of Periyar movement. The scriptures were created. They were written only by the people who are having belief in the God worshipped by those miscreants. If they really, if they want to oppose writers of the scriptures, they have to oppose only the authors of the scriptures. If they want to change, they have to change the scriptures. That is the correct way. Instead of that, they are creating all sorts of problems. This is the ultimatum given by our Periyar movement to the ruling party. Many times it happened like this. You have to take action. Otherwise, we will not come to the field. General public, they will tackle the problem. Then it is the lookout of the ruling party to maintain law and order problem in the states. This is the statement which we want to issue from our side. At the beginning of this video clip, comrade asked, why this Periyar cadets and movement, they are criticizing only Hindu religion, God and scriptures. This is not the first time we are getting criticism like this. During the past, even Periyar was alive, such sort of criticism came. And we gave suitable reply whenever we receive such criticism. Actually, our movement is a humanist movement. It's a rationalist movement. We don't have belief in God. That is the thing. Whenever we say God means, it is applicable, equally applicable, God of all religions. Periyar propagated like that only. But all religions, they are not equal. As far as this land is concerned, the popular religion is Hindu religion. What is the difference between Hindu religion and other religion? Hindu religion is the only religion which insults its subjects. No other religion. They are insulting their own subjects. In the Hindu religion only, in the name of God, in the name of religion, people, they are treated inhumanly. In no other religion, people, they were denied of education. There is no dictum, so-called divine dictum, in the respective religious scriptures. Only the son has to carry out only the occupation of the father. There is no dictum like that in any other religion other than the Hindu religion. What Manuspriti says, it is the legal code of the Hindu religion. The Varna Shrama, that is a principle, is available only in the Hindu religion. It is dividing the people, Hindu people, into Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaisya and Sudra. What is the meaning of Sudra? Can any of these miscreants, the saffron carrots, whether they can give the solution, what is the, can they spell out what is the real meaning of Sudra? In the scriptures itself, it is clearly mentioned there are seven negative meaning for the word Sudras. Sudras are the major toiling population in the Hindu religion. One of the meaning says, Sudra means it is a son of a prostitute. Which religion says like that? Hindu religion only says like that. No other religion teaches its subjects inhumanly. Then our criticism, we do criticize all the religion, all religious practices. We have to discriminate which religion insults us more. We have to criticize more. We have to do propaganda against the religion more. It's quite natural. In that way only, we are criticizing more about Hindu religion. It doesn't mean that we are not criticizing other religion. It is not like that. Equally, basically, our is a humanist movement, atheist movement, rationalist movement. That is the thing. This is the same reply that we have given during the past also. Now also, we want to give the same reply. Another thing is, they are claiming, among the four cadets, Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaisya, and Sudra, the supreme cadre is Brahmin. There is no other superior hierarchy in the Varnashara Dharma above Brahmins. But they are claiming the identity of Brahmin. Brahmin, the terminology is not a standalone terminology. Whenever one person says that he is a Brahmin, means it is a, there is an implied meaning, that is another category called Sudras. They can say, I am claiming my identity as a Brahmin. It means indirectly you are pointing out some other person in your religion as Sudra. Sudra means son of a prostitute. Is it a proper way? Is it a humanist way of treating people in the same religion? This aspect we are exposing to our fellow brethren and sisters, irrespective of the social hierarchy, all the women, irrespective of the hierarchy, they are the bottommost layer in the Hindu religion. Necessarily, we have to criticize. Our movement is for equality for all. Our movement is providing equal opportunities for all. in that way, anyone who talks about equality, necessarily they have to criticize Hindu religion. Anyone wants peace to all, necessarily they have to talk about against Hindu religion in this land. It is a necessity. During the past we did, now we are doing, in future also we will do the same propaganda. Let them oppose ideologically, let them dispute, we are ready to face them. Ignoring all the reply given by us, they are repeatedly, they are asking the same question as if they are not, by that what is their agenda? They want to cut the people. That is the ultimate agenda of those miscreants. This is the thing I want to narrate.
Yes, thank you. Thank you for briefing your views on the particular issue. And you have well said that the question, why you are criticizing, like why we have been criticizing Hinduism for a long time. Thank you, sir. Thank you on behalf of Periyar Screen. Welcome, sir.